Hello there. In this video, we're going to look at how you can enable AutoProctor on your own website. If you've taken the demo test on AutoProctor, you basically know how it works. As the candidate starts the test, we gain access to their camera, the mic, and the screen they're looking at. And for example, if they switch the tab to open Google or ChatGPT, that gets tracked. We take a screenshot. If they have someone else assist them by joining them as they look at the screen, the camera feed detects that there are multiple people looking at the screen, that becomes a violation and so on. So throughout the test, we detect these events real time. And based on all these violations, we calculate what is called a trust score. The lower the trust score, the more likely we think they cheated on the test. And also the proctoring report will have all the evidence based on which we calculated the trust score, right? So let's say you've taken the test on AutoProctor, you like how it works, and you operate an e-learning business, or you're part of an online assessment solution team, and you want to integrate proctoring. So you already have the quizzing or the online coding platform, and you want to enable AutoProctor on that. We make it very easy for you to do this. This video will show you how. The main benefits are, we offer what is called a JavaScript SDK. So this integrates with your code base, and the result is that this is completely white labeled, right? So you can use your own branding. You can change the look and feel. You can change the functionality. All this is completely customizable, and everything happens on your site. So neither the candidate nor the creator of the test has to come to AutoProctor at all, right? So if you own a website, abc.com, everything's happening on abc.com. And as this video will show, you can go live in minutes, right? It's very, very easy to integrate AutoProctor into your existing solution. So if you come to this page, and then if you click on Try Playground, you will see some code, and you will see a bunch of options, and you can toggle a few of these options, click on Start, and you will see AutoProctor work within this website, right? So on this web page. But obviously you have your own code base, and so let's say you want to copy this code into that code base and get it to work. We will show you how you can achieve that. The way I want to do this is I want to actually create a very quick quizzing solution that becomes sort of the boilerplate, almost a placeholder. And then we will layer AutoProctor on top of it. Okay. I've actually used Cursor. So this IDE Cursor. So it is using Copilot to generate some code. Okay. So I've given it a prompt. Of course, you can use your own IDE, right? This is just so that we can quickly get up and running with some code. So I've said, create a simple HTML file of a quiz, show me two MCQs, and I've given some styling. And I said, there's a submit button, and I'm clicking it, check the answers, and show an alert of how many were right. Okay, so this was the output it produced. Let me just copy that, right? So I'm going to copy this into this page. And let me open quiz.html. Okay, so this is just this code. Okay, so this simple math quiz from somewhere, simple math quiz. So this is just this code, right? And it has two questions. It has that random alphanumeric character, which you're calling quiz ID. And so let's say I select maybe one correct. So we've got one or two questions correct. Okay, so of course, this is very, very simple. Yours will be far more complicated, but this is for illustrative purposes, right? So you have this. This is supposed to represent your own either quizzing solution, or maybe you have any online test for coding or communication skills or whatever it is, right? So we have this up and running. Now we want to enable, you can see all this here, right? The question is hard-coded, and then the answers are hard-coded and so on, right? So obviously this will come from your own database. Now what do we want to do? We want to, this is the second prompt I gave Cursor, enable AutoProctor's JavaScript SDK on this. Use the test attempt ID that you're generating as part of the payload. Okay, what does this mean? For AutoProctor's proctoring, we don't really care about the candidate per se. We don't care about their first name, their email. We don't gather any of this information. We don't even care about the exact test that you're using this for. So it could be quiz one, it could be coding challenge one. We are sort of blind to it, right? It doesn't even matter which attempt number it is. So some solutions may have the same candidate attempt the same test multiple times. It doesn't matter to us. The only unique identifier of a proctoring session is what we call a test attempt ID. Okay, so it doesn't have to correspond to a single test. For example, you may have within your system a quiz followed by a coding test, right? So obviously they'll have different test IDs within your system, but if you want the candidate to take this as one session, right, they need to sit and finish both at once, you could combine both of them into a single test, okay? And that test is what we call a test. I mean, that test will have a test attempt ID. So when the proctoring happens, it'll happen across both tests, okay? So the test attempt ID is the only sort of required parameter, okay? So I'm saying use the test attempt ID that you're generating as part of the payload. I'm also telling it to use this for the client ID and this for the secret. Client ID, client secret, basically uniquely identify your account, right? So when you register as a developer, you're given what is called a key pair, a client ID and client secret. These are credentials that we've created just for the video. They won't work after the video goes live. And also the client secret should never be exposed like this because it's a demo. I'm asking the front end to handle it. When you actually take this live, you should ensure that the client secret, all the code corresponding to it happens, is written in the back end, right? And I'm saying set record session as true and show how to video as false. We'll come to these. Now, when a candidate starts, or you know, starts a test that has proctoring enabled, the first step is that they must grant permissions to their camera, mic, and so on. Okay, and we also do a bunch of checks, whether the candidate's face is visible and so on. These take a few seconds, right? If everything is, you know, perfect, then it probably takes about 20 seconds. But sometimes the candidate may not have enabled camera access. They'll have to go and grant camera access, right? So in a typical test, maybe the questions show up immediately, but if you're using AutoProctor, you should not show the questions right away. Maybe you also have a timer, right? The timer countdown should not start until AutoProctor is up and running. And the way you know AutoProctor is up and running is we emit this event called AP monitoring started. Okay, so it's a JavaScript event, and I'm saying don't show the questions until this is emitted, right? So here you saw, if I just reload the page, questions show up immediately, right? But in when proctoring is enabled, we need to ensure that the candidate doesn't see the questions until the AutoProctor is up and running. Otherwise, they may see the questions, then they may deny camera access, then reload the test, but by then they know the questions, okay? And also I'm saying, when the submit button is clicked, first call AP instance.stop. So I'm saying stop AutoProctor, because once AutoProctor stops, then all the evidence that have been gathered, they get uploaded to our server, right? So we need a few seconds there. And only after that, check the question to see if they're correct. So in your system, you may be redirecting them to a separate page, right? You should ensure that this event is emitted. So if this event is emitted, it means we have uploaded all the evidence successfully and AutoProctor is all done. And only then should you do whatever you do, right? As a callback to the submit button. And then I'm also saying, after the alert is dismissed, load the proctoring report, okay? Now, this code you see here, okay? That argument is part of the prompt, is actually just code from here. Okay, script src cloudflare, you'll see script src cloudflare, right? So I've just given the code from the playground, right? I'm telling copilot here, I'm telling cursor that it must use this code from our own website and then integrate that with the quizzing solution that we have, okay? So it generated this, and I'm going to copy that. I'm going to paste it here, okay? So let's look at the code changes. You'll see here that now it has a crypto.min.js. Now this is basically for the client ID, client secret, okay? You will not need this in your production. It's just here because of the hashing that we need for client ID, client secret. This is the only additional file that you need, okay? You have to include this JavaScript file, autoproctor entry.js, right? And then there is some stuff it's written for initializing proctoring, and so on. Now, again, this generate ID, generate hash, all this will move to your backend. Okay, get credentials will move to your backend. Now, when proctoring starts, we create a new AutoProctor instance. We set it up with proctoring options. You will see here that audio true, num humans true. These are basically, this is saying if you want to detect audio, right? If you want to detect number of faces looking at the screen, if you want to record the session, right? If you want to detect multiple screens is if they have multiple monitors, right? All of this is just code, okay? So if you change this, then if you set this to false, then audio will not be detected. So there's no noise detection. if you have having multiple tests in your system, and each test must have a different setting. Let's say quiz one needs audio to be true and quiz two needs audio to be false. Then it won't be hard coded like this, right? So you have your database, and in the database for quiz one, you'll have audio true and quiz two will be audio false. So you'll just get this from the database. It won't be static like this, right? Show how to video false is when AutoProctor loads, we have a how to video. If you don't want to show that to the candidate, you can set that to false. So you've set up the settings, and then you create the new instance, and then you do dot setup, and then you do dot start. Okay, so this is Proctoring has started. Now, once it starts, like I said, it takes a few seconds and access must be granted and so on. And we then emit the event AP monitoring started. So the loading message goes away, right? The loading message you saw there, it said Proctoring start initializing Proctoring system. You know, Copilot has basically said, okay, hide that, show the quiz content. So this is the equivalent of starting a countdown timer and showing the questions and so on. And then also say proctoring. Okay. So this is when the proctoring starts. And when the quiz is submitted, we first stop the quiz and we wait for, stop proctoring and we wait for the event, AP monitoring stop, to check the answers, right? This is again the equivalent of you submitting the quiz or redirecting them to the results page or whatever. You need to wait for this event to ensure that all the evidence are uploaded and then redirect them. Okay. So, and there's also the proctoring report part, right? After, like I told it here, once the alert is dismissed, then you show the report, the proctoring report. So let me save this. Now, if I open the quiz, you see it's hot reload. So it started, it reloaded the page automatically. And the first thing I get to see here is share the screen. This was not there before, obviously, right? Because this AutoProctor will running and we are saying check for tab detection. The candidate has to grant access to the screen. And you'll see the questions are not displayed yet, right? Because AP monitoring started has not been emitted. Okay, let me go ahead. It says initializing. Now it's checking the camera, it's checking all that. Great. So the quiz has loaded. It's not proctoring. It says noise detected, right? Obviously, because I'm talking. Now let me close my camera feed. It said no face detected, right? Because I blocked my camera. Let me move to a different tab. So this is the equivalent of candidate opening, say, ChatGPT or Google and finding an answer. And then I come back. Okay, so I'll submit the quiz. You see, this is coming from AutoProctor. It says finalizing data, right? So that was where the evidence and so on had to be uploaded and it had to be finalized. This is what we had earlier as well. You got 0 to 2 questions correct. Let me say, okay. So proctoring has stopped and the report also loaded. Okay. So this, of course, when you build it, these things will have to go to a different route. The candidate most likely will not see the report, right? This is only meant for admins and so on, but I'm showing you the full functionality. You could see here, so it switched to a different application. This is just because I clicked into when you do this, it not work this way. I clicked into the application, but you will see that I switched to this tab, right? So it's taking a screenshot of that. It's actually taking a screenshot of my Loom as well. Noise detected. If you play this, it'll play the audio. Me blocking the camera, it's detected this. Right, so this is the proctoring report. Trust score is very low because I committed so many violations in just less than a minute, right? And then tells you the other violation that occurred. If I do session recording, you will see with session recording is basically almost like a video of what the candidate did on the test. So you will see here, okay, where the cursor moved, you know, what they typed. We don't have a text box here, but if the candidate typed something, that would be shown. So this is also very useful. Session recording is also very useful. With just that record session true, you're able to get, with record session true, you're able to get session recording up and running. It just show up as a separate tab and you'll be able to see all the candidate interactions. So typically if the trust score is low, we suggest that administrators look at the session recording and they'll get a much better idea of what the candidate did on the test. All right. So going back, we started with a very simple quiz. It just had a couple of questions and then we said, okay, let's integrate AutoProctor. What does that involve? It involves adding the AutoProctor JavaScript file, and then it involves setting the proctoring settings, right? So you have all these settings and initializing AutoProctor with these settings. And two changes you'll have to make to your current system. You'll have to wait for AP monitoring started before you actually start the quiz, right? Show the questions and so on. And you'll have to wait for AP monitoring stopped to then look at the submit the quiz basically, right? The test has to be submitted after this event is emitted. If you do these and then you're able to this, you know, getting the showing the report is as simple as this, right? You just need to say show report and pass along get report options is just giving some user details and then the you know you'll give the test attempt ID. You just have to do that and then you will get this. Now, the advantage of having something like this is within your DOM. It's not like an iframe. So if you wrote some CSS and said, make this gray, you know, bright pink, it will be bright pink because this is part of your DOM. So you can completely customize the UI as well as the functionality. All right. I'll leave a few links in the description and you'll be able to basically try this and also integrate this with your quizzing solution. Thank you.